structure I have.
I can't even say that, no.
I can use a real forceful grip now, you see how, grab the plate like that, and I'll be pushing here. Pulling, and have the piece nearest completion, then I'm down to using maybe just a 1/16 of a, or an 1/8 of a square inch. Tiny amount of construction, early on. Okay, the left side of my body, force is coming around here, we're turning counterclockwise, and I'm leaning right into it. If you ride with the force, then it goes into an oval shape. So you hit it head on. Now I see this as kind of scooping like that. I want to clean this clay soon, or I won't be able to raise it in there. Turn. So push on, I'm under it. You brought up a lot of it that time. That was good move. Left arm is not locked in, because all body movement, as I said before, is based on the segment of the circle. So if I have everything locked down here, it's going to come right to me. See that structure? Under the thumb. Skeletal structures.
Hello in there.
And I only use the amount of water I need. I just put a thin coat on it. You know, I'm not just see people that are. In fact, I was taught this way. Put you down here and squeeze the thing, bathe it with water, and then you end up with about a gallon down in there. Just use the amount of water you need. Just saving face in front of graduate students with a lot. Okay. I'm lifting right off that point, and the clay I'm lifting is being shaped. So I'm lifting right there, and anyway, the clay that you're lifting, which will be symbolized by this finger, is shaped. And unless you do that, then, as I said, after you get a double wall. If we went in here with this hand, like this, quite horizontally, then the clay would come out like this and form an independent wall and then peel off. Now, if this is good grip, you can lift that weight. What you do is you tilt it so that you're lifting them off this point, you see, and then you're shaping the clay with this angle, you see. Or here's another good grip. You lift off that knuckle, see the thumb is involved. You can move the thumb over there to shape the clay you're lifting, and you lift right off that point. If you go in there too flat like this, I see people, I saw Beck yesterday with his rib that the person was flat. Of course, he may have been just correcting, but then you can't lift anything. You see, you've got to have a little tilt. And of course, it's easy to do because you have the radius bones. And I assume that's what they call it, is because they'll work, you know, they'll roll through the surface. See that jealous left hand? Now I make a register. See it form right there? So when I lift again, I'll be right under the clay. But that's the other thing you've got to keep telling yourself over and over again. If I don't have a right hand, I don't have a left hand, I have a set of hands. They're like draft animals, like workhorses. Oxen, they work together, you know, one doesn't pull at a different rate than the other. These two work together. If there's some activity that eliminates the left hand, then it should be involved in just steadying to maintain the habit, you see. Because there is a misconcept in this culture now that your left arm is there for balance, to keep you from sagging. You see, here it functions like washes through. Would you talk to the camera on that? Sag clay still has some on me all over, and that grabs all of the clay. It's real grabby. And my water is still pretty clean. But a lot of people will throw a slip like this thinking that they're getting better lubrication. Well, they're not. Clean water reduces friction more. See that jealous left hand? I don't even think about it. You know, it's there. Take an eternity to come off that path. Pushing out, and they're opposite one another, and I'm using the broad grip out here, and I've got three fingers on the clay, so if the inside hand decides to drop back and move ahead, I still have fingers under it. So I was favoring the middle fingers. They have a tendency. When the piece thins down, that's when you get into trouble. If that inside hand, you should stay opposite. And as I said, I guess last week, that you get a pseudo lift on, you think you're lifting a lot of clay, and that inside hand is just full of head, and then you're getting that big bump of clay on the outside, and you think, boy, I'm going to raise this thing to the ceiling. And you're not raising a damn thing. The clay is just feathering through there like a rope through two valleys. You know. So we went through the shape armpit just as long as
we did. Don't repeat jokes.
Did that pick it all up?
Yeah, it might have.
See, he gets some triple force inside, and there's a little water in there, and he throws it out to this edge, you know, and then it can weaken it there, so I try not to let it stand there a whole lot. I'm going to give it a thin pool of water here and see if we can... Stress breathing doing for you. On bigger piece, you can commit suicide. We got it wider. You know, if we did it once, we can do it again. Let's what you need to consciously think, and this is the people are throwing a lot, when you get down there, hold there for several revolutions. Once you think you've got your hands aligned, they have a tendency to get down there and then take off like a bat out of hell. Because you're anxious to get up here into the danger zone and see if you're going to make it. So anyway, you hold several revolutions, and then you start off the bottom, you know. So I get, you see, I'm down here. That inside hand's kind of pushing out, the outside hand is resisting a little. You can see a dark line there. And now I start up, you see? And I'm kind of pushing out a little. I left an extra bump there, and I guess just trying to teach. Straight lines when you're expanding, that you're going to span out in, well, I've exaggerated there. It's not writing well on this wax. But you think in the terms of a straight line rather than boldness, and then that would be the lift of the piece, and then this would be, and that doesn't have much body. The body is here. Shoulders about there. Well, not his shoulders, but this whole area of the shoulders.
back in, you see. And so you've got your lift coming up, the body of the piece, and then the shoulder area, and then finally when the piece is done, you have the lift. I don't know if that's... set up an electrical charge. That'd be a neat idea if you had an electrode here and one there, and then when you got a little jolt. And I keep looking inside, because it should be identical to the outside. And the lift off the bottom should be nice. Always. And if you want to look in. Because I can sit here with a raincoat and all. A lot of people now, you know, I saw a thing on Channel 13 where a guy had a brush burner drying the clay out. And I kind of go the other way. I just throw a dryer. And I don't need the brush burner. He uses a lot of water. It's about beautiful shapes. Nothing wrong with doing that, except it's just kind of scary hitting that. Got a little more water. Hard in case you can fall out of the seat that comes for somebody. It's kind of a security blanket, you know. I'm not in there real feminine with. Yeah, I maintain my masculinity. Thank you.
Or maybe it's the art director behind it.
Probably the art director.
She wants a surprise ending.
Well, that would not be a surprise ending. As on practice as I am throwing, the surprise ending is when I have a few standing. But I don't want to hear that. Oh, you're so human, you're lost. Well, I don't want that. I want to remain a pseudo deity. Again, note the applying the water, it's where I need it. It's not running clear down to the bottom. And with the clay, we have that, a few people that are new to clay, we have a kind of that romantic way of saying that the clay loses its soul when it becomes too wet. And the soul is the ability to stretch and recompress. And then I always make an analogy to the love egg noodles. An overcooked egg noodle will not support its own weight. When you pick it up, it'll just mush in like so much Vaseline and fall. And a properly cooked egg noodle, when you pick it up, it plays that way. The egg noodle has soul. Name for
You see, I...
You've got a
problem. Yeah, I could quit right now. And it'd be perfectly fine.
Yeah.
But if the demonstration, then we gotta go that damn extra mile. But what we should do then is push this area right here down. We have a tendency always thinking up on the wheel, like we hate to trim the top, because we're gonna lose an eighth of an inch or that type of thing. So with the rib in this hand, I can't get down there. And because I want to push it in, it's not real necessary. But this hand will probably just be holding like that, and then I'll push this, and then that should feather across. Or it can just be a total tragedy, and then turn the sound up to get it all up. Oh! Okay, so here we go. Sense now, we'll go have a cup of coffee and come back in 20 minutes. If I were a person with good sense, I'd one hand, two hands, and air inside is my third hand. You see. If I open this and blow into it, it will expand, but I risk some cracking there. But you can do it gently. But I can do shaping out here now without too much risk, because the air inside will resist.